How much help? Well, they're still trying to go on Akaka here, but he will be able to easily survive. Now the turnaround comes. No-Tail going to be blocked out, but they get the first blood onto the Doom.
Doomlings
come out, though, and that'll ensure a turnaround kill, and maybe even more. They snowball off, trying to go for crit. Another shard comes
there.
In. Crit very low, but they can't quite get the range. And old 11, he's got to back away from Fly. Decay up in 5 more seconds, but then Rip. No. Healing Cell.
The real Doom has joined the Doomlings.
No, Kaka's going to be able to join the rest of them, but Fly, he's more than tanky enough to live through this, and he will challenge the Doom as best as possible and create more space for No-Tail.
I don't know if I've seen this. When the Doom respawns with his Doomling still available, if you die again, do you just keep spawning him over and over?
He can drop incredibly low, but thanks to the Decay stacks, as well as the Mango and then Soul Rip on himself, he will be able to survive. Double Avalanche, the snowball goes out, but Kaka is tossed back. They bring him into the snowball, now trying to get away, but they get the kill again. More Doomlings cut out, but this time around, Old 11 doesn't really have the opportunity to set up a turnaround kill. Caught. He does have Snowball. Crit's pretty low. He dodges the Avalanche, but it's going to be the Tether slow that keeps him at bay, unable to really chase down Crit effectively unless, oh, barely gets that kill. Just before he has to die to Tiny, but at least he gets the exchange. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, they caught Moon Meander. CTY comes over and lands the power shot.
Yeah, still doing a good job of getting trades, and most importantly for OG, they are punishing the offlaner.
Miracle. Turn around here before he gets his level 6. Just that one stun. It looks like it's going to be enough. Miracle dove all the way in. And even the Eye Shards comes out from Old 11 to make sure there's no escape for this Alchemist.
Makes him such a dangerous threat in the mid game.
Old Chicken forces out another Chemical Rage from Miracle. He's still got plenty of battle charges, though, on him. Starts coming forward, does manage to get the extra slow. They also have Old 11 here for the extra burst damage, but the turnaround is OG. Pop the Tombstone.
Oh, he does
heal out. Nice snowball save, and the unstable concoction unable to finish off Lanham. It's going to be Fly who may be dying. Slow rips himself, keeps himself
alive.
Old
11
has a lot of zombies out. Looks like they will be able to get that shot on the Moon Meander right in front of the Tier 1 tower. But Old Chicken is low. The Fisher brings him low, and now Miracle is going to be in the neck, going to the next target. Old 11, he does still have mana, though, has a snowball. Snowball ready to go, but no opportunity for a turnaround. Moon Meander going for the TP out. Old 11 sees him. Snowball will stop that TP. It looks like Moon Meander will die as CTY catches up. The body blocks are easily going to ensure kill. But a nice fight for OG. It seems like Kaka coming in. Block out. Oh, No-Tail. This is going to be an opportunity for CTY.
Oh, that shackle.
The shackle shot. Right onto the range creep.
Oh, that's hot.
The toss board. Old 11. He gets set up and tossed in. Miracle claims that one.
I thought the Shackle was going to be enough, but not enough mana for that power shot. What a play by No-Tail, though.
Not wanting to give up any ground to OG. Old Chicken putting himself on the front lines. He knows that he's more than tanky enough to deal with a combination from No-Tail, especially with the Living Armor. Shackle shot onto the two of them, but there's the interrupt from Moon Meander with a two-man Fisher. They're still going to be able to get some damage onto No-Tail. There is no relocate to be able to save him. No-Tail gets blocked out, healthily enough. Snowball comes in. They go straight into No-Tail, trying to lock him down. They throw out the Doom onto the Earthshaker, preventing that turnaround, but the undying Tombstone is going to be doing so much work against E-Home as they now are forced to retreat. OG are going to look for those pickoffs. There are still some healthy members here. Old Chicken, he's going to be the first target. Moon Meander, his Doom is almost run out here. He's going to be able to get off and looking for more. Shackle shot gets laid out in No-Tail. Crit's keeping him alive though, and E-Home won't be able to go for that kill. At least not right away. CTY, he needs to help out his side heroes. Echo Slam. Old 11 does get hit by that stun. Managed to get off the snowball, dodging the toss. He'll get a little damage onto the Earthshaker, but will stunned up by the unstable concoction. He's still alive somehow, but at least he ensured a turnaround kill. Kaka's next up. No-Tail keeps on going for him. Combination, more than enough. His low on net worth had no HP. And OG win yet another fight.
And Crit did such a good job of keeping everybody alive. Doesn't stick himself on just No-Tail. Constantly rotating around. And this is what makes IO such an annoying hero. They're gonna go for more though!
CTY! He did not expect No-Tail was stalking him the whole way through. 9-12 now as the items come rolling in for OG.
No-Tail might have stayed, but too long, but Crit's right here.
He doesn't have the mana for a relocate, but the movement speed is enough to stay ahead of Old Chicken. And now with the refill on the bottle, Old 11, he's going to run back into this one. Snowball laid out, actually going through to Moon Meander. He's going to try and get the punch, but the unstable concoction is there.
There's
first.
There's the Wisp relocate.
Stunned up in. Fly's going to be the next target, but already the Tusk is down. And now with the Wisp relocate in, they're going to be able to go on to Lanham. Good overgrowth factor, and Fly will be taken out with a Doom on the No-Tail. They're actually controlling him pretty decently, but Crit, no! He gets the relocate back out in time. E-Home just shy of finishing him off.
That could have done so much. They were just a little bit too split in their focus. No-Tail was doomed up, I believe. And they decide to right-click him a few times and then switch targets, but Crit They have to know that the relocate is about to bring him out. The Tiny is not the
be able to easily win it.
They don't have a CTY for this one.
They're gonna come downhill. This is gonna be real bad. And he's gonna be the first target up in the air.
Away.
Back down. No Tails just beating him to a pulp. He's already got a monster kill streak, and he is a monster on the front lines. Moon Meander stuns up old 11. They'll look for more now. Todd's forward. Kaga, he's gonna be the next target. Almost has the feature ready to go, but they turn around as they found Lonin. They caught him out with the counter ward and ward combination. Take three and make it a Roshan as well.
With the way that OG have itemized, and the Tiny being this strong, I don't actually think there's a way for Ehome to fight into them. Like, this game is starting to kind of get out of hand at just 22 minutes in. Completely made the right decision, backs against the wall with one game left to go. They decide to make No-Tail the core.
The real hard part for Ehome at this point in time is Doom aren't going to be able to provide the same kind of pressure on the side lanes.
Look how much damage the Tiny does right now. So much evasion on him, and he's got the Wisp.
You think that Living Armor and Glyph are gonna mean anything? No Tail. He'll just keep on going. He's got Old Chicken now. The Fissure actually separates the two of them, but he's still reaching over that Fissure to be able to get the kill. The Snowball doesn't quite save the Viper in Old 11. He's got to limp himself away. The zombies are all on top of him. Same goes for Kaka, but OG are just focusing on objectives at this point in time. Kaka, whoa, the toss! Hello, Fly jumps a long way past the Tier 2 tower, but Lottom, he's still going to be the target of No Tail. Coming forward is Crit, and to get up enough damage to CTY, now flying zombie into the air. Fly back down, and Soul Rip will be able to keep him alive until a Tomb comes out. Moon Meander makes sure to get the deny on that one. Doom is punished for his positioning, though, as OG can continue deep into the Ehome base. Nice Snowball dodging the unstable concoction, but doesn't really mean much. Moon Meander trapped against that Tier 3 and to get off the Fissure, gets the aggro off of him, and CTY, he can't stop the TP out. OG, they dive fearlessly into Ehome's base and walk away with plenty of kills.
Oh, and Chicken. The Viper's gonna go in here.
He could actually challenge No-Tail with Crit backing him up. They did get amazing tackles on Miracle. Barely gets off the unstable concoction. Turns around onto CTY. No-Tail, he dropped low enough, but they can't keep up with him. Miracle's gonna be the target instead, as Old Chicken keeps him in place as Shackle Shot to ensure that Miracle will in fact go down. But it's No-Tail's Tiny, which is worth 17,000 net worth, and had that Aegis, that was the critical kill that Ehome desperately needed.
The weird part about that engagement is that most of it's centered around their Tier 4 tower.
Is Desolator just for cheap damage? Seems MKB is out of the quest. BKB, perhaps?
I think Maelstrom is okay because there's no BKBs on the side of OG quite yet. No-Tail still has the axe. He's gonna try to trap
separation. The Fissure onto Old Chicken. Immediately the target. Old Chicken's gonna be able to get a lot of slow. No-Tail is shackled up to a range creep, but he's already down to half HP, but he still has that Aegis to work with, and he's clean through Old 11, and he'll get Old Chicken as well. The old people are going down, and now an Echo Slam. Moon Banner comes in for the side, catches another two, and even gets the Fissure onto CTY, but OG will turn to take that Tier 2 tower, and Alchemist, who's doomed away, doesn't even care. He out-regens the damage from Ehome, and OG have plenty of sustain to keep forward into the Ehome base.
There's just too many core heroes for the Doom to focus down. And what a setup by Moon Meander, being able to isolate two heroes out by himself. The other two desperately trying to climb that wall, and as soon as they do, they get Echo Slam.
But again, they have this Aegis. There's just no way they can catch him. Miracle does stun himself with the unstable concoction, and maybe Ehome. Maybe they can catch somebody on the way out. The Doom still needs another 7 seconds, and even then, he doesn't have his ultimate. So Ehome are forced to watch as OG bounces. Got a Glimmer Cape now for the Wisp. Fly has a Force Staff that we saw that one earlier. Kaka gonna be the target. Here is No-Tail. They're just trying to run down this Doom. He does have to back up the rest of his team, and No-Tail has to be careful now. Crit, he pops the Glimmer Cape, ready to go with the relocate, but still, No-Tail, even if he's doomed up, he's right-clicking for so much damage. They do get the Shackle Shot on the side.
This might be your best opportunity.
The Snowball comes toward Fly. He's going to be the target of Focus Fire and does end up going down. CTY,
oh, they have to kill No-Tail before this Doom ends.
Catch No-Tail. The Wisp buys back. He needs to really try and save No-Tail. He comes with the relocate in and will help No-Tail with the tether, but he's locked in by the Fissure, and another great Shackle Shot as well. Ehome, they're gonna try and get out of the situation. Echo Slam farther up, looks like they've caught CTY. They'll get that one kill. No Chicken, he goes down as well, as Miracle's able to catch him with an unstable concoction. And third is the Tusk. Ehome thought they could escape, but no chance. OG commit the buyback on the Wisp, and it seems well worth it as they're on their way to force down a GG from Ehome.
And that was a relatively quick one. Fantastic positioning by Fly. We haven't talked about him all game, but that Tombstone, it was the nail in the coffin for Ehome. He gets it on the high ground. So many zombies spawn out. zero way for them to recover that fight at that point.
So a fairly dominant game number one for eHome. But OG strike back in game two, and we will have the full series just to be expected from two top-tier caliber teams like eHome and OG. We'll see you guys in game number three, but first, our analysts.